Firstly, thank you very much for coming here. I know it's late, I know you're all tired. So why don't you start with a simple demonstration of a game, which is this. So this is a Simon game, which is basically a memory game. So what happens is that this pie, the pie will play a sequence. And then I have to repeat the sequence back to the Raspberry Pi. Yeah, and it goes on and on. It gets longer and longer until eventually either I can remember the sequence or I get bored of it. So basically, how is this thing done? So I'm sure most of you here are probably familiar with what the Raspberry Pi is. For those who don't, it's a mini computer. It's a small credit card size computer, which basically has most of the functionality that you expect a computer to have. So what is interesting about this is that it can be used in certain maker projects, and it can be used for people to learn about how a computer system would work. So it has this cool thing called GPIO pins, which is how I control the circuit here. Moving on. Well, the Raspberry Pi is pretty cheap. It's about 50 SGD, and it can be expanded to connect multiple Pis together, and it's easy to program. As a year 5 or JC1 computing student, in our class we do learn Python code, and as such, even as a JC1 computing student, we are able to program the Raspberry Pi with Python. However, it does have some disadvantages. It's not very fast, it has limited processing power, and the GPIO pins are limited, so it has not many programs and apps, but yet it is sufficient for all purposes. So this is a simple diagram of what the GPIO pins look like. There is 5-volt power, which is what's powering the LED lights, and then there'll be a ground, of course, for the electronics. So each GPIO pin is configured to have two states, a high voltage and a low voltage state, and this can be controlled programmatically with the GPIO module. So, okay, so this is quite a self-contained enclosure. All you need is a HDMI board, the wireless adapter, and the power cable. So the Raspberry Pi 3, which came out not so long ago, will have Wi-Fi enabled, but this is the older version, so I have to use an adapter. So this is the circuit diagram. It's not very complicated. It's just 3 light emitting diodes and 4 push buttons, 2 of which are rising edge, 2 of which are falling edge. So these are all the lights and buttons. Okay, so how this is done is with Python software. So firstly, we import the rpi.gpio module, and then there will be certain functions such as gpio.setboard, and then each of the individual pins will have to be set up as an input or an output. And then ultimately, to control the pins is a simple function called gpio.output, and then which pin, and then whether it's on or off. I will show you the code, but the slides are kind of glitchy. So move on. Okay, so as fun as this Simon game is, it's pretty fun, but there isn't much applications that you can do with it. So what I'm trying to illustrate here with this Raspberry Pi is that it can be used to create a home automation network. So as this FOSSASIA conference, everyone's talking about the Internet of Things and how we can connect all the appliances in our house to the Internet. So basically, imagine that the Raspberry Pi already has all the circuits contained here, and they'll have sensors, which are these input buttons, or they could be something like a temperature sensor, it could be something like a humidity sensor or light sensor, and then the actuators can be LED lights, can be a fan, can be an aircon, can be anything. So let's say you want to control this from a remote device, a computer or a phone. So there's this thing called PubNub, which I'm using, which is simply a free online software, free to a certain extent, that will receive messages and then relay them over to the Pi. So it's like a broker. So over here I have a web interface, which is just done with a bit of bootstrap and HTML. And whenever one of these buttons are pressed, it triggers a JavaScript code over here. And whenever one of the buttons are clicked, the JavaScript code would use PubNub to send a message. And you'll send through PubNub to the Raspberry Pi. So, can you see the Python code? Yeah, so this is a Python code. On top you report RPI GPIO, and then bugnut is a module for this purpose. And ultimately what happens is that whenever a message is received by the PI, it reads through the message and then checks what is the content of the message, and it will switch on the respective lights. So in an ideal home automation setup, so how would this work? For instance, we are talking about it could be a temperature or humidity sensor or whatever. So the information will be tracked by sensors and then uploaded or sent via bugnut to an online platform. So the user can check on the app, or what's the temperature in my house, or has there been an intruder in the house? It could be a motion sensor. So when the user checks this, the user can then use the app to control the appliances in the house. Also, this can be used for complete automation in which appliances in the house respond intuitively based on the surrounding conditions. Okay, why home automation? Firstly, it's convenient. You don't have to leave the room to switch on the light or the fan or whatever. But more than that, it can also be quite secure because you could set up a motion detector, and then when you're not at your house, if there's any motion detected, then the motion detector can be connected to a camera to take a picture, and then it will probably send to a web app or a phone app, so the user who's outside the house can check and say, oh, it's just a dog, or oh, it's a burglar, you should call the police. So it's also economically and environmentally friendly because there could be a lot of data that's being collected and monitored, and then you could see about, oh, how is this, how much electricity am I using? Are these lights being on unnecessarily? Like, even if it's bright, the lights are still on. So the Raspberry Pi can also automate that process and switch on the lights if it's too bright, or switch off the aircon when it's cold enough already. So moving on, why the Raspberry Pi itself? Because it's quite cheap comparatively. Adding all the electronic parts together, a home automation system can cost as little as $100. And it's really easy to program. Like, not a lot of experience in code is required to be able to understand how all of this runs. And it's intelligent, which means that as shown by the Simon game, any input received will go through certain calculations, like can be math, can be random, can be a bunch of modules. And then these calculations will be done before generating an input. So this input is intelligently generated. So based on whatever web application that is, or customized Python program is being done by the user. It does have a couple of limitations though. The Raspberry Pi GPIO system has a maximum of 5 volts of output. So it works perfectly fine for LED lights, but if you're talking about a real light in a room, you'll have to connect that to relay switches, which will then transfer that to AC power. And then, of course, there will be security issues. Like I'll show you later, right now there's a program that controls the lights here, and it can be accessed by pretty much anyone who has the link. So there will have to be password or encryption protocols in place to make sure that only the user of the owner of the house can actually control appliances in their own house. Okay, so we'll do a little demonstration. Does anyone here have like a mobile phone or a laptop with Wi-Fi enabled? If you want, you can try using this website. Please not everyone at the same time because it might cause some issues. Website is accessible by pretty much anyone as of now because there isn't really any security concern. So the lights can be turned on and off, and that is basically how you expect a home automation setup to work. Of course, with more additional add-ons, it's not just lights. But this is what we have so far as a prototype. Does anyone have any questions? If not, then you all can feel free to contact me. Eating, sorry, the site. Yeah, thanks very much for everyone's attention.